for the truth to sink in, to kind of catapult the propaganda. I know the human being and fish can coexist peacefully.
You're working hard to put food on your family.
There's an old saying in Tennessee, I know it's in Texas, probably in Tennessee, that says, fool me once, shame on you. Fool again.
Have you pictured what this planet is going to be like in 40 to 50 years? It's going to be a big smoking ball of shit.
This chamber has no windows and no doors.
I just don't understand. This doesn't make any sense to me.
It is a riddle wrapped in a mystery inside an enigma.
There are some who feel like that, the conditions are such that they can attack us there. My answer is bring them on.
The world will note that the first atomic bomb was dropped on Hiroshima, a military base. We won the race of discovery against the Germans.
They are the focus of evil in the modern world.
We have used it in order to shorten the agony of war, in order to save the lives of thousands and thousands of young Americans. We shall continue to use it until we completely destroy Japan's power to make war.
What if President Obama is completely wrong about Afghanistan and turns out worse than Iraq and Vietnam put together?
I hope it'll be all over television, radio, and the newspapers.
Nobody takes responsibility for anything.
Africa's a nation that suffers from incredible disease.
Where my bitch, nigga? Buy your own damn fries.
This is an impressive crowd, the haves and the have-mores.
Now, you know that guy ain't shit. Sorry ass motherfucker got nothing on me, right? Nothing.
I'll never feel alive. I'll never feel alive.
If this were a dictatorship, it'd be a heck of a lot easier. Just so long as I'm the dictator.
Blow it out your ass! Blow it out your ass!
A lot of fine print in your plan, Mr. Vice President, in all due respect. It is, I'm not so sure 80% of the people get the death tax. I know this, 100% will get it if I'm the president. So I hear the voices, and I read the front page, and I know the speculation, but I'm the decider, and I decide what is best, and what's best is for Don Rumsfeld to remain as the Secretary of Defense.
At this Thursday, ticket counters and airplanes fly out of Ronald Reagan Airport.
Our enemies are innovative and resourceful, and so are we. They never stop thinking about new ways to harm our country and our people, and neither do we. We cannot let terrorists and rogue nations hold this nation hostile or hold our allies hostile.
I couldn't imagine somebody like Osama bin Laden understanding the joy of Hanukkah.
We got an issue in America. Too many good docs are getting out of business. Too many OBGYNs aren't able to practice their love with women all across this country.
I don't think we need to be subliminal about the differences between our views on prescription drugs. I hear there's rumors on the internets that we're going to have a draft. We're not going to have a draft, period.
We want to promote families in America. Families is where our nation finds hope, where wings take dreams.
I am not going to level criticism at local and state officials. Mayor Nagin and most mayors in this country have a hard time getting their people to work on a sunny day, let alone getting them out of the city in front of a hurricane.
The aggressive impulses of an evil empire.
Surely God is mad at America.
Brownie, you're doing a heck of a job.
He's sending hurricane after hurricane after hurricane. How do I make sure that New Orleans is not overrun by Mexican workers? It's time for us to rebuild a New Orleans, the one that should be a chocolate New Orleans. And I don't care what people are saying, uptown or wherever they are, this city will be chocolate at the end of the day. This city will be a majority African American city. The way
wants it to be.
And to the C students, I say, you too can be president of the United States.
Hello.
It is the calling of our time.
Hello.
To win this war on terror.
I do not need to explain why I say things. That's the interesting thing about being the president. Maybe somebody needs to explain to me why they say something, but I don't feel like I owe anybody an explanation.
And America needs a military where our best and brightest are proud to serve and proud to stay.
I loathe Kim Jong-il. I've got a visceral reaction to this guy because he is starving his people. It appalls me. I feel passionate about this. You know, they tell me, well, we may not need to move too fast because the financial burdens on people would be so immense if this guy were to topple. I just don't buy that. But I'm not leaving. I should know where I am. It's meant to be. It's not going to happen. And therefore, there's no need to try to hide from a terrorist.
I guess politics never stops.
Cemeteries around the world are packed with brainwashed, dead soldiers who were convinced God was on their side. America prays for God to destroy our enemies. Our enemies pray for God to destroy us. Somebody's going to be disappointed. Somebody's wasting their fucking time. Could it be everyone?
You know, this town's full of politics. People just say what they want to say.
You got to really go something to play the race card with me. My office is in Harlem.
I wish the president had paid more attention to the history of Iraq before he got in there. The idea that we're going to win this war is an idea that unfortunately is just plain wrong.
I guess politics never stops.
Shame on you, Barack Obama.
Well, I don't think so.
The Republicans are not very friendly to different kinds of people. They're pretty monolithic party. They pretty much, they all behave the same. They all look the same. And they all, you know, it's pretty much white Christian party.
There are white folks, and then there are ignorant motherfuckers like you. There are white folks, and then there are ignorant motherfuckers like you. There are white folks, and then there are ignorant motherfuckers like you. There are white folks, and then there are ignorant motherfuckers like you.
Injustice anywhere is a threat to justice everywhere.
There you go. Why don't we just ask Osama bin Laden, Osama Obama, what is, since he won by such a big amount.